streams of abundance flow. Blessed be your name. Blessed be your name.
When I'm fundraised section.
Yes. So, 2 Kings. What have we been able to identify in 2 Kings?
So, okay.
Yes, Prophet.
Elijah and God.
Yes. What was the relationship?
Well, he was a servant, but Elijah was his also his mentor, but
yes.
He also did not receive all of what Elijah was trying to mentor.
Yes, and that can be found in chapter 4, the relationship between Elijah and Gehazi that Prophet Valerie is speaking of. Yes, very true. So you can have someone very close to you and still not adhere to the wisdom and knowledge that they are sharing with you. Okay, Prophetess Cynthia Dawson. Which one had he spoken?
What chapter?
Okay. So he threw the tower accent on the spot by the stone. Which is by Enrogel and Paul, all his brothers, the king's son, and all the men of Judah, the king's servant, but did not call the prophet Ben-Nahash as the mighty man and Solomon his brother. He called not.
What was he doing? What was he trying to do?
Yes, he was going to appoint himself as a king. He was appointing himself as a king before it was actually that King David anointed him. So he was doing it himself. He was appointing himself. He wasn't waiting for the anointing. He was waiting for the form of appointment.
Joab sent the Cushite. He said, go tell the king what you have seen. So what happens is, you see where the Cushite man goes to David to tell him, but there was someone else who wanted to go in front of him. But David had sent the Cushite, but he ended up getting him. So you see where many cultures, many attitudes, many things were happening in this time. This reign of King David was very powerful. And so when you see how David moves about, he has the prophet in his ear. There were some times when God would speak to David in his ear, directly. Anything you want to add to that? David had successes and David had struggles, but yet he was a man after God's own heart. And so he knew that some things were going to come back. I want to say to you, the grace of God will cover, even though David went after Bathsheba and did all that he did, that was not the most important thing for him, because war was really relentless back in that day. They would cut you up, or they would cut you off, or they would do something to you. They would just kill you. Just kill you. And so you had to have some kind of heart for that. But yet, in the midst of all of that, he had a heart after God. That, I don't know how all of that was housed in there, but it was all housed in there to be able to do all of that. And God knew how to separate that. He knew that his love for him was genuine. So when we look at the preparation of Samuel was when he was a shepherd boy, which prepared him to lead God's people. We look at Samuel as a courtier, and he ended up being in the center of his own court. He was the king. Then we look at him as being a strong ruler, which he was an outlaw. So all of those things prepare him. So what are the things in your life that are preparing you for where you're actually going? They are side by side. There's something you're growing up into. And you don't have to see it. You just have to believe it. So if you believe that God's going to secure you, that's what David did. That was what made his heart after God's heart. No matter what happened, all the pursuits, it really wasn't about Saul. It really wasn't about him as a man. It was about him in that anointing. He respected the anointing of God in that man. And even though the soldier killed him and said that he asked me to do it to finish him off because he was in torment, David still had that man killed.
Teachers, the lesson has ended. Please rotate to your announcements. session. Thank you.
All right, well, let's get started. We started in the book of 2 Samuel, and that was with Prophet Kenneth and Prophet Dominique. So, let's hear what you learned. Now, I thought I told you to have a seat. I told you to have a seat and don't move. It's just here walking around on this morning. That's the only one I'm mentioning because I told her about it. Okay, here we go. All right, come. Y'all looking like, y'all know my elder, right? Y'all know my elder, that's all I'm saying. Okay, all right. Okay, come on, talk to us about the book of 2 Samuel. Oh, come on. You know what? She had too much information over there. This was her problem today. She had so much information, she couldn't get it all out. She was talking 1,000 miles a minute. She was trying to get it. She was loaded. She needs a class. We're going to set up a class for 2 Samuel because she had so much information. So I know y'all got something. Come on and talk to us. Yes.
Good morning. Is it on? Okay, thank you. Good morning, Prophet Olympia. What I got out of it, that God's grace will strengthen you for whatever it is that you have to do. Also, I learned that Samuel was he was the last of the ruling judges, and also that Samuel means God has heard.
Good. That's right. Excellent. Anyone else? Yes.
Also, it showed us God had prepared him as a king and as a shepherd and as the center of the court. And also, the whole thing was about the triumph and the success and all the different troubles that he went through. But as God only looks at our heart, not on the outside of us. And that's
it. There was a lot. That's good.
Thank you. What I got out of it was that despite the fact that David was a warrior and he actually killed people in the name of God, God still considered him to have his heart at the end. So that was good to know.
Amen. I didn't want to skip. I was waiting for it to come out. Anybody have anything else to say about that? That David was a character.
Yeah.
Anybody else? Say, come on, talk to Olivia.
What I learned about David, he was it's not a game, because he was loving two different women, Michal and Bathsheba, and then also he killed 200 men. The agreement was 100, but he did 200. He killed 200 men. Again, he killed, and he had to bring back their foreskin so he can get Michal. But what I did like was that David was, after all his drama that he was going through, he was still trying to have God's help. Come to seek out God's help. I have faith with God.
Okay, good. That's good. Because we find, yes.
Sorry, I was teaching, but I did get a little bit of this when I was studying the time. That what I learned from David is that no matter how faithful you are, sin is still so close to you. And so you have to keep guarded because you can't succumb to sin.
Mm-hmm. No one is exempt. And David was a rascal. David was a mean man.
Yes.
See, nobody wants to talk about David like that. David was not, we say God called him a man after his own heart. But David had some real issues. Anytime you put a woman's husband on the front line to be killed so that you can have her, that's an issue right there. That was no joke. Yeah, we know David slew Goliath and he, saved Israel and all that. We understand that. He was supposed to be, but David had some real issues. He did some things that were not very godly. We don't want to talk about that.
That's right.
Amen. But yet and still, God's hand was upon him. It's something about the hand of God being upon you to do a work, as opposed to God's hand being removed from you and you trying to do a work. God's hand was upon David. That's why David was able to, we don't want to say get away, but he got by with so many things. And it seems like, God, how could you allow this? Because God had purpose for him.
Uh-huh.
A prophet's internet said, she said, what God has for you will show up when you grow up.
Yes.
Jesus.
Oh, I like that.
Oh, that's good. I had to write that one down. Yes, it will. When it was time for David to grow up, what was for him showed up, the kingship. Amen. He was back in doing taking care of the sheep. But when it was time for him to go to the next level, then there came the anointing.
Yeah.
Amen. So I saw that. I don't want you to think that David was this wonderful man and God, you don't have grace and mercy. No, David was a warrior.
Yes.
He was a warrior. He didn't care.
Yes,
look, he cut off the foreskins of the men's penises. Come on, that's a big deal.
And brought
that's
it back and gave it and to their wives.
Come on, say that last part.
In another version, he brought back, he cut off their foreskins, but he brought back the penile so that the woman could have it for a diary. He was ruthless.
Come on.
He was a man of war.
That's some mean stuff.
He brought it back to him like, in a box.
That's horrible. You know, that's not nice. So when you think of David, there are two sides of David. But God loves him.
Hey. Here, Mother Jordan. Here, Mother Jordan.
Oh, Mother, yes.
You know, what I learned about David also, if you read the Psalms of David, he was always confessing to God the things that he did that he know was not pleasing. He was always asking for mercy.
Yeah, he was. Over here, they said he had to.
Yes.
Amen. All right. But thank you, Prophet, that you just had so much to teach you. So much. Now, let me warn you, teachers, because these books are meaty. They're weighty. Can't get it all in. If you could just kind of give us the outline, give us a couple of stories in there, you're more than fulfill your time. Her 4 minutes went, she didn't know where it went. It was, she was in there and she was out of there. Because it's a short period of time, but there's so much in the book. You want to make sure that you don't over, don't get me wrong, it's okay if you put it on paper, you just can't say it all. Amen. Okay, but that was great. Yes,
Mother. As I was listening at Prophetess Antoinette when she was teaching, she said David was a man after God's own heart. It brought out the fact that it's not for us to judge a person. The Bible is to judge you, not that you be not judged. It's not for us to judge. For me to judge you, for you to judge me. It's to leave it up to God. That's not our business.
Right. No, it isn't. And that's where we get that, because God called him a man. Now, we can say that. God said that. So God knew what he was doing in the leadership of David. Amen. Just like he knows what he's doing in each one of us. So though it may look sketchy now in a person's life,
Yes. You
don't know what all good God's trying to work out in their life. They may have to go through that sketchy period
Right. To
get to the palace, if you will. You don't know how God is moving in a person's life. That's why, you know, if you like it, we love it.
That's right.
Because we know God is working in you and through you. He's taking you somewhere. Amen. You may just be a testimony for someone else.
Mm-hmm.
We don't know. So that's why we don't judge lest we be judged. Yes. Amen. All right. Very good. Very good. Come on. Yes.
I would just seriously, good morning, everyone. I would encourage you to go and get the book.
It's going to take about 5 minutes. Maybe
a book that we all have to read in the leadership
capacity
days gone by. It's going to help you to understand the dynamics of this whole thing with David. Because you gotta remember, David, his ruthlessness was not, he was trained to be ruthless. Because Saul wasn't nice in him. And Saul was his mentor. So he carried that level of ruthlessness in his involvement into what God intended him to do. So it started somewhere, and he carried it in a whole nother level. And ruthlessness, when it comes to kingdom, is a natural habitat. Because you can't be nice ruling a kingdom. And you'll find that out as you go along inside those books.
Okay, amen. Well, let's move on to the book of 1 Kings. Let's see what you learned out of 1 Kings.
I've learned that the tribes became Northern Kingdom of Israel, and the two tribes of Judah and Benjamin became the Southern Kingdom of Judah.
Yeah.
Right.
So all you have to do is look at the outline, y'all. Let me give you some hits, chance here. Come on. Anyone else? Look at 1 Kings.
I learned about.
Adonai.
Adonai.
Uh-huh. Where he exalted himself to the point that he slew sheep and oxen and called his brethren, which he considered the kings of sons, and did not call the prophets and his own flesh brother.
Okay, good. Anyone else? Okay, getting a mentor-mentee relationship out of the book of 1 Kings. Was it so much that y'all can't remember, or I'm trying to get this here, but something I saw, and I'm not sure what this was. And it's up here? Okay, well, go ahead.
David mentored Solomon.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Well, there's some easy ones in here.
Elijah mentors the widow woman at Zarephath.
And the older men, yes? Did they talk about that?
Yeah.
I'm sure they did. It's up here.
Yeah.
Okay. Anything else about the book of 1 Kings? Say it again. Right, the old prophets mentioned the young prophets, yes. Mm-hmm. Good. Anyone else? Okay. Anyone else want to say anything about the book of 1 Kings? There's so much information here. I'm really, you know, maybe there was it was too much information. I think that's because we get to these books right here. You talk about history, and there's just a lot of it. For teachers, you know, as we get into these books, try to get the theme and get some points in there or some story, just a couple, because it's too much for the people. It's like they're on overload now.
Yeah.
It's really what's happening. Yeah. Because it's not that y'all are teach. I heard y'all. Amen. Okay, 2 Kings. That was Prophetess Wendy DeCruz and Sister Lorraine Ajua. Yes.
Because they bothered me.
Okay. The mic is here. Please see the mic.
Yeah, there was some sick stuff going on, and they were actually eating other people. I don't know if they were starving or whatever, but they were eating other people.
Yeah. They were eating people, so they were cannibals.
Yeah. Yes.
Did y'all know that was in here?
No.
Prophetess.
Basically, I like to talk about where she said that God has a lot of patience and he gave them a lot of warnings to follow them, and nobody didn't take heed to it.
Yep.
That's right.
What I learned was, although there were so many mentor-mentee relationships, there was still a lot of chaos. Nobody still wanted to do what they were supposed to do. It was ridiculous.
Sound familiar? You know, we look at it and say, oh, they were horrible. They had all these good people before them, they had all these mentors, and they had all this information, yet they still did. But guess what? Look at us. It really is no different. The more things change, the more they stay the same. Amen. All right. Well, these lessons are waiting. Prophet Sam said, that's good. I heard you said that you were going to give them the mentor list.
Yes.
No,
let
them
find it for themselves.
Yeah, you did what you were supposed to do.
Okay.
Yeah. One thing I want to say, when you're doing the exercise, you're supposed to talk to the person next to you.
Yes.
Everybody's kind of in their own way. It was quiet as a mouse. I'm talking throughout the whole place,
yeah.
Not just in where the class where I was sitting. So make sure that you get a partner and that y'all work together.
Yeah.
So that you can come up with the information. I know you had it, but you've got to work together. Come up with the information.
What I found was that some of them didn't have Bibles for their phone, so they didn't, you know, have
to. Okay, well, now if you don't have a Bible coming to Sunday school, then you're really not coming to Sunday school. You come to profile. Because Sunday school is all about learning the Bible. Come on. So you need to bring your Bible, okay? Everybody said, whether you have it on your phone or a physical Bible, everybody needs a Bible. Is there anyone without a Bible?
God sent his son. They come. child.